Hey, 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 what is up, Yappa fam? So, you guys, yes, this is something new, where you're either listening to this podcast or you are maybe watching it on YouTube. But yeah, we're doing something, I wouldn't say it's new, but I would say something different. So, for those of you guys who have followed Yappa 238 since the beginning, we actually started Yappa 238 in the YouTube channel with the Yappastolic podcast, which was really cool. And they're about an hour long, 45 minutes plus, and we would talk about, you know, a litany of different subjects. I think we got to 11 podcasts total, and then just the workload. I don't know if you guys know the backstory. Again, if you guys have been following Yappa 238 for a while, you guys would know that, you know, it was taking me 20 hours a week just to edit a podcast. And so it was just super, not only time consuming, but very tedious. And I did not know what I was doing. And I didn't have my voice. I didn't really, because when you jump into an endeavor and you don't know how it works, you just keep doing it and doing it and doing it until you get good at it. Well, the endeavor I jumped into was delivering content with my voice and video and stuff like that. And over time, I refine my voice to where I'm able to speak and do, like, I'm working on one takes right now. Just, you know, we're always growing, and you guys know that I talk about growth a lot here on Yappa 238. But that's one area that I'm growing in now. It's like being able to shoot an entire video or record an entire podcast without, you know, having those or unnecessary pauses and stuff like that, which I'm working on it. I just did a ton over the past few minutes that you've been here, but I'm working on it. Anyway, so, excuse me. So the podcasts are about an hour long, and we're taking a ton of time to edit. And it was just, oh man, it was crazy. But, and then the TOTDs came out, and so we started doing TOTDs, and the TOTDs took off. And I don't know if it's just because people wanted video content opposed to audio content, but the TOTDs just took off and blew Yappa up to where Yappa is today. And I had to, in the interim, I didn't have to, but I didn't know what else to do. But I kind of gave up the Yappastolic podcast in order to do the TOTDs. And because that's what was vibing, that's what was going, that's where you guys, you know, were coming to the Yappa 238 platform and joining. So, anyway, long story short, we're at the beginning of 2019, and we're going to start the podcast back up. Not back up, I don't want to say back up, but we're going to continue putting audio content out there just in this format. And so before, the Yappastolic podcasts were about an hour long, and now they're, you know, we could still do hour long podcasts, which 9 times out of 10 we will. But what's more easily doable, I guess you would say, for myself, is a shorter podcast, maybe 20 minutes, 30 minutes, or even 15 minutes, like a mini cast. I was thinking about calling it a mini cast, but I thought, you know, like, it just didn't sound right, like the name. So I was like, you know, okay, we're just going to stick with the Yappastolic podcast, and we'll and we'll go from there. But anyway, so kind of an intro to these, the new style, I guess you would say, of podcast, of the Yappastolic podcast. And yeah, so they may end up an hour long, you know, just talking. We'll see what happens. Anyway, so you guys are here, you guys are listening to this, you guys may be watching this on YouTube or wherever you guys are consumed the Yappa 238 content. But anyway, it's the beginning of 2019, which I'm excited about. And I kind of just wanted to talk to you guys about a few things as I'm actually with my mom's side of the family. We're going to Tahoe to, you know, just have some family time and play in the snow, because in California, the only places we get snow really is north of where I live. So anyway, we're headed there right now. And I was thinking, I was going through content that Yappa 238 has produced, and I was thinking about 2019, and in thinking about 2019, honestly, I'll just be completely transparent, and in no way, shape, or form am I trying to condemn or be condescending or come in that kind of condescending tonality. But I know that young apostolics are setting a lot of goals for 2019, and it's beautiful to see them, it's awesome to hear them, And to know that young people are out there doing that is like, it stokes me up. Like, I just love it. But while we're doing that, I was thinking about it, and it's like, you know, honestly, I'll just be transparent with you guys, because you know that's what Yappity 30 is about here, transparency and honesty. If we're not doing it led by the Spirit of God, goal setting and, you know, trying to figure out our 2019, it's kind of almost null and void. Null and void meaning useless, meaningless. Because if we're not doing it Spirit-led, and we're supposed to be apostolic Christians being Spirit-led, it's kind of like, then why are we doing it? You know what I'm saying? How can we be Spirit-led when we're not engaging with the Spirit? I remember Paul in the New Testament, I believe it was Paul, he talks about, you know, how do you think we can start in the Spirit, being baptized in Jesus' name, filled with the Holy Ghost, obeying the Bible, start in the Spirit, and finish this race in the flesh? We can't do that. We can't finish this race in the flesh using carnal means. We have to be Spirit-led all the way up until either the rapture happens or the day that we pass on into eternity. And so thinking about that, every single year, every single moment, in fact, needs to be led by the Spirit of God to the best of our ability. Now, I'm not saying that you won't have your carnal moments. I'm not saying you won't have your moments where you're 100% in the flesh and you have to step out of the flesh to step in the Spirit and that struggle. I'm not saying we won't have those struggles, but we have to first struggle and not just give in to the flesh and stuff. But we also have to make sure that we are doing our best to be Spirit-led. And so that brings me to kind of what I wanted to talk to you guys about today. And that is your prayer life. You know, I'm really hoping that in 2019, one of the goals that you guys have on your goal list is to start or grow your prayer life, or to continue your prayer life. Because sometimes I know that, like, you know, you may not be in the position to grow in time. Like, okay, I'm going from an hour a day to 2 hours a day. That may not be the position that you're in right now. And God doesn't need your, and this is kind of a trippy idea, but God doesn't need your prayers for Him to be God in your life. Now, that doesn't mean you don't pray, but it's not how much you pray. It's not how good you sound while you pray. It's not how big and, you know, the grand words and the awesome scripture that you can quote while you're in your time of prayer that moves God. It's your sincerity in communication with Him. It's almost like the Pharisee that was standing on the corner in front of everybody, or at least the parable that Jesus tells. He's standing there and he's like, you know, saying these big words, and Father God, I'm thankful that I'm not like the man that does this and that man over there who does that. And he's going like that. He sounds real good, sounds real eloquent. He's waxing eloquent. And that man in the corner who's ashamed of all the sins and the wrongdoings that he's done, he's the one that God's having respect for in regards to his prayer. So you don't need like a high volume of prayer in order to touch God, but you need to have that relationship with him. The point of prayer is for relationship. Okay, it's not to just say we prayed. There's a lot of people who pray. The Buddhists pray, the Muslims pray. There's a lot of people who fast, the Muslims fast. Okay, even secular people, fitness people fast, okay, and they're definitely not getting anywhere with God, all concerned and focused on their bodies, okay? So you can do all those things, but that's not where it lies. It lies in what happens when you pray and what happens when you fast. What happens when you pray is you get a connection, a relationship with God. What happens when you fast, you submit your flesh so you can be more spiritual. And you can deny yourself and you can, you know, seek temperance in your life. So, and cultivate discipline. And so I'm thinking about that, and I'm like, you know, young people, like you guys, and you know, I speak to myself as well, definitely, we need to make sure that we maintain our prayer lives. And if you don't have a prayer life right now, don't worry about it. Don't feel bad about it. You can't erase the past. You only have right now. The moments in the future, they're shaped by what happens now. And your past is just your past. It's gone, especially when Jesus comes down and he washes in your blood and you repent for the lack of communication with him and the lack of relationship building with him. My goodness, God forgives that sin like he would forgive the murderer's sin, like he would forgive the liar's sin, like he would forgive the whoremonger's sin, like he would give the smoker sin, the druggie sin, right? So just like he washes away all that sin, he'll wash away your, you know, the lack of you not, you know, communicating with him and developing that relationship. So develop that relationship. You're not too, you're never too late. You guys probably know this song, Never Too Far Gone. You're never too far away from Jesus where you can't start a relationship with him, okay? Especially as young apostolics, you didn't murder anybody, you're not backslid, you're listening to this podcast, you can start a prayer life, okay? Don't worry about it. If you haven't started one, start one now, okay? And there's a lot of different ways you can do it, and I'm just going to be transparent, 100% transparent. I personally have done it. I've been in the place where I've been trying to start a prayer life and been spotty. I've been in the position where I would pray solid for like 3-6 months, and then, you know, the next 2 months there was no daily prayer. Okay, I've learned, and I've kind of like that trial and error stuff. And from that, by the help of the Holy Ghost, Him leading me through it, He's taught me how to develop a prayer life of an hour a day. Not just develop it, maintain it, and grow it. Okay, so I've been in the development stage, like failing here, failing there, and all that stuff. And then the maintaining stage and growing stage. Now, I say that to say, Yapa 238 has produced a prayer course on how to start and found a prayer life of an hour a day. Okay, and I'm not, this isn't like, I don't know, I'm just coming from, I'm just being straight up, like real transparent. I wish I had this when I first started, but apparently, first, it wasn't like readily available like that. I just couldn't go log on to a website and find, you know, prayer training, like as in depth as we do, as we get into it in this prayer training. But there's books, but I remember ordering the books, and for whatever reason, they never came. I won't name the place where I got it from, but I would order the books on prayer, and I'd order it multiple times and didn't come. And I finally got to the place where I was thinking, like, okay, these people who I'm trying to learn how to pray from, they had to start somewhere. Maybe they just started praying. And so I was like, okay, let's wake up at 6:15 in the morning and just pray, see what happens. And I'd pray for 15 minutes. And that started me on this journey of finding out how to pray. So I didn't have this resource when I started, and but I want to get you guys, because the times is too close. Like, the coming Lord's too close. We need some spiritual apostolic young people who are ready to take on hell with a prayer life. And so we don't have time. I would love to say it like this. I hope this doesn't sound presumptuous, but you do not have time to be kind of flopping here and there to trying to figure it out. We got to have it like right now, because God's coming back super soon, and you need to learn how to be a witness. You need to learn how to operate in the gifts of the Spirit. You need to learn how to, you know, pray for someone in faith and a miracle be performed, because when miracles happen, people come and people are converted. Okay, prayer also changes your spirit from being selfish to selfless and being a servant. And if you want to be the greatest in the kingdom, you have to be a servant to all. And if you don't have a servant's attitude, a servant's mindset, you're not going to be the minister that you want to be. You're not going to be the woman of God that you want to be. You're not going to be the man of God that you desire to be if you don't have that spirit that comes when you're in the prayer room. When you're with Jesus, you begin to look like Him, act like Him, talk like Him, walk like Him, live like Him. And when you're living like Jesus Christ, you're going to get the results of His ministry. You're going to get the results of who He is inside of you. And you need that hour a day of prayer. You need that prayer time. Someone asked me, does it have to be an hour a day? Yapa, does it really have to be an hour a day? What about 15 minutes? The consecration of an hour a day, the forcing of your flesh to pray for an hour a day, you forcing yourself into a prayer room for an hour, that right there is a power of the hour of prayer. Another power of the hour of prayer is you're giving yourself time to walk in the Spirit, to learn the Spirit, of God. There's a Yapa Live, one of the greatest Yapa Lives that we've ever done on Yapa 230 about prayer. We taught on how to pray through, and the dangers of just praying through. Okay, a lot of people don't think like this, a lot of people don't know this, but there is a danger to just praying through. We cannot just pray through. We need to pray through and thrive in the other side of the pray through. How do you do that? How do you start in that direction? You start in that direction with an hour a day of prayer. And the training, the video training app at 238 has, will give you that. And I'm passionate about it. And I love prayer. Okay, I'm not saying I'm some angel or, you know, I can, you know, pray for 5, 6, 7, 10 hours. I think the longest I prayed was like an overnight prayer meeting. But, you know, half the time, my main focus was trying to keep myself awake, to be honest. Now, I have done prayer, like, you know, longer prayer meetings. I don't want you guys to think, like, I don't know what I'm talking about. I've prayed for 4 hours. I did 4-hour prayer meetings using the same methodology taught within the video training in regards to fasting, four-day fast, 3-day fast, 10-day fast, liquids only. I'm trying to think. I'm trying to validate myself because I don't want you guys to think that, like, I'm just some dude who doesn't know how to pray. But anyway, I've been operative within the gifts of the Spirit, operated within the gifts of the tongues, interpretation, the prophecy, miracles of healing, of faith, like all that stuff. So I'm not saying that to brag. I'm just saying that, you know, I've learned through prayer how to love people and how to operate and want to see people get the Holy Ghost. And so you pray for them and God gives them the Holy Ghost because you love them and you're channeling the love of God through you to them. So anyway, if you want your 2019 to be absolutely phenomenal, however you do it, you don't have to get the app at 230 training. You don't have to, you know, go through that. You can go read another book or you can go get another session or whatever. You know, whatever works for you, but you have to have that if you're going to be successful in 2019. It's like a must have. Okay, because I see a lot of, you know, good young apostolics and they have the discipline of reading, you know, these awesome motivational leadership books. I mean, all these different awesome materials that I read. You know, I read, you know, how to be a better leader and how to, but you, it's, I don't know. It's some, you can tell that they, that spiritual foundation is missing and they're leaning more on the arm of the flesh and there are the arms of the Spirit and the hand of God. And so, do I believe you can read all that stuff and while being super spiritual and being like Spirit led? Yes, you can definitely do that, but you don't want to get out of balance. And there's a balance that God will lead you into if you're sensitive to Spirit, which only comes again by prayer. So my friends, Yappa fam, I wanted to do this quick podcast, kind of introducing you to some of the new ways the Apostolic Podcast is going to go about. And also just to introduce you guys to the training from Yappa 230 and the understanding of why you need to pray for an hour a day. And like your 2019 is not going to be, I'll just be completely transparent, you know, I hope I don't make any enemies from this, but your 2019 is not going to be what God wants it to be and what you desire it to be in God if you don't have a clear vocal hearing from God. Okay, I'm not saying that he has to speak to you audibly. I'm saying that communication with God. So we want that. That's what we want. That's what we ought to be going after in 2019. And so I really hope that, you know, you guys see that. You guys are like, okay, well, that's where I want to go. Because if you want to go there and you have the training, you have the resources available, you can definitely make it happen. If you want some of that, if you want to get in on this, if you want to start praying for an hour a day, click the link around this video. It should be in the description box or, you know, somewhere around this video. And you'll be taken to a page where you can find out more about the training, see what you get with the training, and then go ahead and go through it, check out, join us in the video training area. And yeah, we'll go through it and you can take the resources given in the video training and take it into your times of prayer. Use it as a resource and it would be absolutely phenomenal for you guys. Okay, love you guys. Yappa fam, you guys are amazing young apostolics. You guys are going to change this world. Not in 25 years, though you will, if God tarries. Not in 50 years, though you will, if God tarries. I'm talking about in 2019. This year, you're going to change the world. Next year, you're going to change the world. Next 3 years, you're going to be a completely different person than you ever thought possible. Especially when you're in the hands of God and you're being led by His Spirit and by His ways. Love you, Yappa fam, and I will talk to you guys soon. Make 2019 the greatest year that you can possibly have in God.